us. So here we'll be seeing about the introduction, the DNA of chairs, material choices, lifestyle, innovation, innovative furnitures, furnitures to this context, room by room, room furnitures, kitchen furnitures, bathroom fixings, and children furnitures. So these are like nothing but some of the furniture design which have been developed by very famous architects. The furniture is the one category of design element that lies almost only within the realm of interior design. While wall, floor, ceiling, window, and doors are established in the architectural design of the building, selection and arrangement of furniture within the building spaces are the major task of an interior designer. Okay, so we just to add few, you can see some of the works of people, how they have transformed or designed their furniture, which adds a significance to their, you know, design idea or design language. It has an, you know, peculiar or their signature might be, to be very specific, as one image tells about the significance of each architect in designing their furniture. So these are some of the example: Wiener Panton, Piri Pollan, and these are two examples of, you know, chairs or things that are being designed by them. So coming to the functional criteria, in accordance to the space, first the furnitures are designed. Functional grouping in sense in a living room or in a TV room and these things. Appropriate social distancing. I think so the social distancing word would have been much familiar by nowadays because of this COVID-19 scenario. So this is needed very much everywhere, because not everybody will like to sit very close unless and until you are doing some furniture for a bedroom or spaces which is very intimate. Rather than that, all other spaces, you need to think about proper appropriate social distancing. So adequate flexibility and adaptability in designing a furniture. So lighting and electrical or mechanical services. So these are like the aesthetical criteria: appropriate scale to space function, visual grouping, unity with variety and figure around the reading, three-dimensional composition, rhythm, harmony and balance in the designing of furniture, appropriate orientation. To be very precise, when you enter inside a room, there is thumb rule, they'll tell you some thumb rule that you should not see the backrest of any furniture. So that one thumb rule they'll be seeing entering inside a living room. This is classification of furniture by the plane arrangement. So it can be categorized into tight fit, where you have the place is very less. This is most appropriate for office designs. So whereas you want to spread your, furnitures in a living room or in other spaces. So in accordance to the plane arrangement, you need to arrange the interiors. So these are like some of the spaces where they use loose fit, as I told you, living room. So it's mostly living room. So this is the difference between a tight fit furniture arrangement and a loose fit furniture arrangement. So coming to the DNA of chairs, DNA of chairs are nothing but the historical aspect of history of and the evolution of chair. We call it as like DNA of chairs. To start with the modernistic furniture. So it was start by, this furniture is very similar. Sorry, it's very familiar to you. Gerrit Rietveld, okay? He wanted to focus on just 2 to 3 colors, might be red, blue, and black. And you come to this Charles, this person, Charles, he wanted to, he played an important role. And the well-known architect, Le Corbusier, he also has played a very important role. And you know about this Bauhaus chair, okay? This Bauhaus was like the you know, it was a pre-Nazi, as in before the World War II. Nazi, you know, it was during the period of Hitler. So it was this thing was developed. Somebody is joining, just a minute. So this was like a pre-Nazi Germany, you know, that time the Bauhaus design school was started. It mostly emphasized on industrialization. It's due to industrialization and things like that, they have developed a very, you know, linear, modernistic, not with much of, you know, this cushion work. It will be lot of frame can be seen rather than the cushion work. These are like some of the inventions of Bauhaus furniture. You can see the sling slated chair. This Bauhaus chair, no, 1930. To be very precise, the World War II was by 1945. This is just 10 to 15 years before that, so that we call it as pre-Nazi. And Finland, we have Alvar Aalto. A simple curvilinear molded plywood to give a unique form. This is what is this? Okay, in 1934, you see Alvar Aalto, he has used this kind of furniture design. So you can see some of the example of other furniture design that have been evolved in the history during a phase of time, you know, from the pre-Nazi or pre-World War II time till now. So it is about the material choices. It is about the usage of wood. It can be metal. Mostly after industrialization, it was the usage of metal. When we saw, even in the history of furnitures, we had studied in, you know, in starting in ancient history of furniture, we saw in Egyptian architecture, the leg of the furniture used to resemble the leg of the animal. All those furnitures from the starting, they were using only wood, because it was like more easy to, you know, transform it, or most easy to carve it. This was the reason why during the initial phases of the history they used wood. Comparatively, after that, after industrialization, when they introduced this you know, cast iron, wrought iron, most of the people, they preferred this metal structures, because in industries, you know, you have to, the furniture has to be long, it has to stand the wear and tear, and they were able to mold this. This is the reason why they have started using this metal furnitures. Plastic furnitures, after the invention of this plastic metal, this had come into role. Fabric and upholsters, you know, this is like, now we have lot of designing like parametric modeling and things like that. Lifestyle. Three things to consider before you search what you look. Be realistic about your lifestyle. Be true to your personality. So it's like, I can give you one live example that the chair what I'm sitting now is an wooden chair, which is my grandfather's chair. So why I just want to tell this is because, you know, in this context, you might think, why ma'am is telling all these things? See, I have a very modern chair in my home, okay? I have a very modern chair from Neil Kamal, which is a white plastic chair. But as in faculty and also, you know, preparing notes, question paper, lot of things, studying a lot for the class, I have to sit more than 4 to 5 hours a day. Somebody is telling that my voice is not audible. Still now, class? Still now? Still now not audible? Just a minute, I'll try to adjust my computer. Now how it is? Class, still you have the issue of this thing? Class, still you're not able to listen? class still not able to listen? Sorry, not able
it's to audible, ma'am.
It's audible, right? Thank you. Just a minute, class, just a minute. So I just want to tell an example in this point. Why it is? Because a plastic chair, when you sit, or an woolen coated chair, when you sit on top of that for more than 3 to 4 hours, you know, due to like heat and other constraints, you get a sickness. Okay, sickness, or you know, lot of heat boils in your body and all these things. But this wooden chair, which is which has a force, and it is being done by in the wire la pinnuvaangala, it is like that. It is made or woven by wire on, you know, you can see, you know, both in my is it visible? My chair is visible, class? En chair theriyuda ungalku?
No, ma'am.
Theriyuda? One minute. Can you see this chair?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So in the chair vandha enna na the backrest rendu me vandha enna na wire la pinnirukanga. So it has a lot of nalla air movement nalla irukum. So that is why ipo namba lifestyle pathi pesnom illa. So ipo nariya per pathinga na neenga furniture, when you start designing a furniture, vithyasa vithyasamana shape you people are giving. No, lot of different shape, octagon, hexagon, எல்லாம் கொடுக்குறீங்க. Have you ever thought of like அதுல how will you really sit for a long time? See, just for design purpose னு கிடையாது. Your lifestyle-க்கு வந்து that has to be little suitable. Have you ever thought of that? That is my one of the major question. நிறைய பேர் பாத்தீங்கன்னா the aspect of lifestyle-ன்றதே have not thought when you are designing a furniture. So I thought it's a high time for you to tell about these things, as in like from furniture point of view. So if questions based from this subject vandu eppadi irukona, design and reception table. So it will be exactly like the assignment what I gave you to do. Most of you know, like only 50% of the class is submitted to furniture design. Please others, put some good effort, understand and start doing it. Because this theory part I have reduced from unit 5. Your question bank is containing more of design oriented questions. Hope I am very clear. That is what I keep on telling you, to do your portfolios better than your writing assignments. Please listen to that. Two important questions from this unit 5 will be design and interior for an office space or an architect's office. This is one question. Design and reception table, design and living room furniture, that's a 4-mark answer. So do you think that what all you should first do to first you know, understand these things? So if for kids furniture na, you should have a concept. Office furniture na, mood board you have to do. What design, what is the concept? After that you have to do the section and elevation. Did you see the CAD file what I had sent you, class? Yeah. Respond. So this will be the questions from this unit. It's a very 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 simple unit, and only design based questions you will get. Just a minute, just hold on the line. So when it comes to designing aspect, these things will be, you know, like what kind of techniques you are going to go. whether it's going to be a traditional English style or a country style, loft style, oriental style, a French interior. These are like different architectural styles. What kind of style you are going to incorporate into your design is like the major aspect of this interior design thing. Class, we'll just go back to that, our presentation, another one. So when you, I think so it is displayed, the Word file is getting displayed. Just wait for a minute. Okay. So this is a basic idea. Now we'll see the typological orders. Order, which is means like what are the types of, you know, casework or how it can be. Might be a flat pack or built-in. Built-in and freestanding are like, you know, these are like some of the furniture types and how it has evolved. Movable materials. So material, we saw what are the materials that are used.